Hello.
Hello.
Oh, were you about to strip off?
Oh yeah, I was about to do a striptease. I was just getting ready, just waiting for the music to kick in.
Yeah. What was it you just said that we should have a theme tune?
Start to a theme tune.
If anyone
Right.
wants to write us one.
No, we don't. We really
I'm
don't need a theme
joking,
tune. We
obviously.
really don't. Right. Okay. Welcome, guys.
Hello, Happy New Year.
Yeah, Happy New Year, 2019.
Yeah, I haven't done the transition yet. I still keep talking about this
What?
year as if it was last
What
year.
transition are you doing?
I'm not in 2019 yet, not in my
Oh,
head.
okay. I was slightly
So,
concerned for a moment what you were up to.
yeah.
Yeah, welcome guys. Welcome to our regular Sunday come on and talk to you for an hour kind of shenanigans. If
Shenanigans.
you're new here and you're thinking, what the hell have I stumbled upon? My name is Nick. This is my wife.
Andrea.
We are resellers. That's our job, which means we buy stuff, all of
We,
this
yeah.
assorted stuff,
We
and
sell it on the internet.
sell it on the internet.
On the internet.
And we come on YouTube and talk about it. There you
Yeah.
go. That sums us up. So if you are new, welcome. There is a live side chat if you want to say hello. There are a bunch of people in there. Let's go in and say a few hellos first. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Hang on. There we go. First in tonight was, do you want to do some
Oh,
hellos?
Starly, you beat Lucy to it. Hi, Starly. Hi, Lucy. Baz is in, Amy, Peter A.
While you do that, I'm going to get myself a drink of water
Oh,
because
okay.
I've got a very tickly cough.
And oh, we're there as well. Hi, we're here. Yeah, so welcome, people. Who else is in? Because he's left it hanging, so I need to just scroll down. See who else has joined us tonight. Adrian, hi Adrian. Hope you had a good Christmas. This is very personal skits. And who else is here? Karin, hi Karin. Claire Borden, Caroline, hi Caroline. Sapphire, hi Caroline. How? Hi Caroline, hi Sapphire, hi Chris. Yeah, that's about it. Oh, yeah. Jason's in as well. So hi guys. I hope you've all had a really good Christmas, a really good New Year. And I don't know, some people have already started work. We've been pottering about, we've been doing a bit of stock checking, we've been sorting out the, well, you've been doing a lot of sorting out of the hall and moving it into different places in the
I
house.
like to say I've been easing myself in gently.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I'm officially properly starting work
That was
tomorrow.
lost on her.
You're doing what?
I said I like to say I've been easing myself in gently.
Easing yourself. Yeah.
Don't worry.
Good.
So, did you do a bunch of
Sorry,
hellos?
but that did go over my head. It was meant to be something.
Hey Lex, how you doing? Oh, one of the things we're going to share
Oh.
from the hall, I think you're really going to like, Lex. I might save it till last, just so you've got to hang around.
Just read Stafford Antiques Militaria Millionaire Militaria
Wow,
said,
what a name.
to be honest, I've not stopped working, but I suppose it's kind of like that for all of us. We've still got orders to ship, we've still got, stuff to do, so you never really completely switch off.
Well, we were going. I talked about turning our eBay shop off, and
Yeah,
we
and
never did in the end.
I said no, I didn't want to do that, and I'm glad we didn't because
No,
we had some good sales over
it's slowed
Christmas.
down. Our eBay is quite appalling at the moment, but we know why, because we haven't listed, and I haven't
Yeah.
been relisting because I'm still yet to start my complete stock check, which
Yeah.
you've been
I've
doing.
made a start on that last week and I've marked a load of stuff down and I've had some really good sales. So, yeah, I'm
Moving
quite
off.
happy. Oh, I sold. I had like a 60s, original vintage 60s sort of mod dress and it's been on for over a year. It's been on for ages and I think I just held out on the price because I felt like it was worth as much as I'd listed it for.
So, how
But
much was it on for?
apart from having lots of watches and lots of interest, it never sold.
At how much? How much was it on for?
I think it was on about 25.
Oh, okay. Not
So it wasn't
expensive.
like major. I think I did start quite high and
Oh,
I
okay.
incrementally moved it down, but I didn't want to get rid of it for more than 20 something. But eventually I
Yes. For less than 20 something.
Yeah, that's what I mean. But then I marked it down to $11.99 and it sold straight away. So okay. Somebody's got a bargain. And the thing I wanted to mention and why I'm talking about this is that it's going to somebody who works for Kath Kidston.
Oh, yeah.
It says so-and-so at Kath Kidston. So I thought that was really cool.
So I think it's worth doing, though. I mean, that's basically a half price reduction from $25 to $11.99. So, but it works. It's stock that you've had sitting around for ages. It probably only owes you a couple of pounds anyway.
Exactly. And I just needed it shifted now because it's been on for so long.
Yeah. We're both going to do that. I'm yet to start because, as you can see over my shoulder or over Andrea's shoulder, I have cleared. This was just a heap.
Yeah.
You couldn't really get to the shelves. You couldn't see the back of the office. And it was all from that van load of stock that we picked up from Luke about a month back now. A lot of it we have sorted out that we're going to take straight to a boot sale and clear it. Stuff we don't want to deal with, it's stuff that is of low value or we don't think we're going to be able to shift on eBay. We've got a spare room full of that now. And then the good stuff that I just needed to move so I could use my office is now in the loft. So the loft is now pretty much rammed with so much gear. And the rest of it I've been trying to organize on the shelves. And for tonight, there's no way of sharing this haul. It's just too big. We haven't even properly looked at all of it. There's still, I think, six great big crates in your office that we haven't properly been through. It's crazy. But we've picked out five or six things each tonight that are of interest and that interest us, that appeal to us, or that are interesting to share. So that's what we thought we'd do, just to give you a flavour of the sort of stuff that's in it, because it's so, so random what was in this haul. We basically bought another reseller's stock. So it's, and he bought the sort of stuff I buy and the sort of vintage stuff you like as well.
Did any of you buy Emma Drew's stock? Because I bet that was really cool. She sold it all to another reseller.
Did she?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know. I didn't realise. Yeah.
I didn't, if she advertised it, I didn't see it, but she mentioned in one of her posts that she'd sold it to another reseller.
So. First I've heard about it. So I did put in the title that we have a visitor and people were guessing. I think somebody guessed that Lex was here and Tom. No, and I doubt anybody would ever guess who our visitor is. I'll give you a couple of clues. This guest was bought at auction by another reseller who was outbidding me at auction. No, you're not here, Lex. Don't worry. You're not in two places at once.
She also asked, why did Emma sell off her stock? Because then they're stopping doing eBay. They're not doing eBay anymore.
Hey, Jason. And Bumcrack Picker. Yeah, you've guessed it. We have a visitor. Mr. Tat. Now, you may remember that Zahir and I had a big battle when we did the charity auction. I think he went for something like £80. I bowed out at 50 and then kept bidding after I'd said I'd stopped and then bowed out again at about 70. And Zahir just kept outbidding me. So Zahir bought this, but he, when we met up the other week, he brought Mr. Tat with him. And so his little idea was that Mr. Tat can travel around various resellers. So he's going to stay with us for a while.
Yeah.
And then we're going to send him on to another reseller YouTuber. And he can go and spend some time with somebody else.
Yeah, so he's going to have a few adventures with us first.
So he's going to do the rounds. And we thought on our blog page, which we're going to get back into this year, the link for our blog is below. There's loads of reselling related posts on there. If you're interested in that sort of stuff, he's going to, what I want to do is that Mr. Tat has a little page on there where we share photos of his adventures. So there you go. This is Mr. Tat. And when I was bidding on him, I thought he was like this big. I thought it was a tiny little thing. He's actually quite big. He's like nearly as big as my head. So there he is. I still reckon this is Steve Green's brother from another mother.
He's very effeminate looking for a mister. I know he's got a beard.
Very effeminate?
I know he's got a beard. What's but look this? At his eyes. Look at his eyes. And he's got a little flower on his hat.
He's got some green eyeshadow on.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on there, isn't there, folks? There's a lot going on there. He's got bags of tat under his arms. He's a little bit drunk. He doesn't stand up very well. So anyway, we're going to look after Mr. Tat for a few weeks.
Yeah, too much country cider.
Take him. Too much cider. Yeah. We're going to take him on a few adventures. I think we've got a jumble sale coming up, haven't we?
Yeah, we do.
Like we need any stock, but we're going to go anyway. We might take Mr. Tat along for the ride. So that's our mystery guest.
Steve says he looks like a beardy, effeminate Mr. Potato Head. He does. Steve says, I'm very effeminate, very feminine looking. Question mark. I don't know. Jury's out.
Somebody makes Steve a hat like that. Yeah, go on. It's basically a wicker basket upside down. So, Steve, get yourself a wicker basket, stick a sunflower on it. You're there, right?
I think if you put a bit of green eyeshadow on as well, you know.
Green eyeshadow, yeah. Two yellow sacks under your arms. Yeah. I need this photograph
then
in my
you're
life.
Definitely there.
Right, another thing before we get going, sharing a bunch of stuff from this haul. Thank you for everyone who watched and supported the Beer Backer video. If you haven't seen that, we're helping a fellow reseller and entrepreneur to try and launch a website.
Yeah.
It's not our website. We're just helping someone else to try and get something off the ground.
Yes.
And I need to say a quick thank you before we carry on to people that have backed us through that on our page. So thanks to Sue's Piles of Shame, Jeff, Allison, and Jack Country Crafts for your donations.
Yeah, thank you so much.
And Luke wanted to say on that video, there was a lot of feedback. Not all of it was positive, but he particularly wants to thank people that have sent messages saying what they didn't like about it, what didn't work, what they don't think is a good idea. And he is acting on all of that. He's busy implementing a way that you don't have to sign up for an account if you want to pledge a donation.
Okay, that's a good idea.
They're doing a workaround for that as we talk. And I think he's waiting until that is in place to allow everybody to create a Beer Backer page. So if you have messaged him to say you want to be part of it, and I hope many of you other YouTubers or creators do, there's going to be a slightly longer delay now while they implement this payments without having an account thing. So I hope that made sense. I'll get Luke back on in a couple of weeks and we'll talk through it all anyway. So yeah.
And also, I think there was a little bit of confusion about the video that some people thought that you were basically doing it because we were asking people to send us money or whatever. And that wasn't the point, really. I mean, obviously, we think it's a cool idea. We want to be a part of it, but the video was more to help Luke launch it and to support him. But
in order to help show how it all worked, we had to be the guinea pigs. But the point for me is that to help Luke get it off the ground. Yeah. So if you do want to get involved, I would much prefer than sending us money that you go and set up a page yourself. That's what I like. And quickly, before we share things from the hall, next Thursday, I'm going to be on Lonnie's channel. Garage Flips. I think it's going to be about 6 o'clock our time. And then the week after that, on our channel, we've got Pommy Picker, who is Rod, who's an expat from the UK, now living in Australia, and he's a reseller down there. Really interesting chap, so I can't wait to chat with him. Right.
Andy said, if I back the channel based on quality advice, how do I know Andrea gets her 95% share?
95% of quality of... So I'm the 5%. Wow. Right.
That's funny.
I'd better do less talking. You better take over. What's Tom saying? No one will want to back me anyway. Yeah, they will, Tom.
Yeah,
everyone loves you, Tom. Okay, so that's covered that.
Yes, what's next?
Should we share some tat?
Yeah,
we've actually got stuff to share.
Should I share this? Because I've been dying to have a drink of my coffee and I can't because I want to show this mug. This was in the hall.
Like, show it a bit nearer.
It's full of coffee currently.
So like we didn't need any more mugs or any more Christmas mugs in our life.
No, I've decided it's not a Christmas mug. It's just a winter themed mug.
It's a Christmas mug. How Christmassy is that?
It's not, because there's nothing Christmassy about it. There's no Christmas trees. It's just a snowman that's and just, Mickey in the snow.
That's just an excuse to not put it away with the Christmas gear.
So I can use it throughout January and February because, you know, it snows during January and February, sometimes in March. And I can get lots of use out of it.
Whatever.
So that was my favourite item in the hall. It was my Mickey Mouse.
The first thing you did was steal an item from the hall. But there were some other mugs that you're quite keen on.
I'm not stealing those. I'm going to list these.
Are these all the same sort of design? They're kind of... Mm. Oh, no. This one sort of goes in a bit.
This one does as well.
There's a Tigger one. I briefly tried to look these up before we went live. There's not much value in these. I think these aren't particularly sought after.
No, maybe a tenner.
10 to 12 pounds, I'd imagine. It is a Disney store. A
Winnie the Pooh one as well.
Is that Disney store exclusive?
Rumbly Tumbly Pooh.
Disney store exclusive.
Sorry, I was just thinking about the poo stories today.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, a couple of mugs.
So they were really cool. There were some other mugs that we liked. So there was a nice Starbucks one, which I didn't. It was a Christmas one, but I didn't get around to listing it.
Did you not? So, Christmas is gone now.
I know. It'll be there for next year.
And there was some Epcot.
Oh, yeah, the Epcot ones.
Glasses, weren't they?
I forgot to show those. Should I go and get them?
Yeah, if you like. I'll show something else. This is quite cool, to say the least. What do you reckon comes in a case? In fact, I think I might have shown this when we were picking up the haul. What would come in a case like that? It's like something out of Harry Potter, isn't it? So vintage. That's very cool. Any Mario mugs? I don't think there were any Mario mugs. There was quite a lot of mugs, a lot of which I don't think are worth reselling, so I think we're going to get rid of a bunch. There's a lot of ceramic stuff as well, most of which we haven't even been through yet. Typewriter. No, it's not a typewriter. Maybe we didn't show this. Ah, there we go. Adele says accordia. Well, accordion. I assume that's what you were trying to... Yeah, accordion, Adele. Put it in again. This is really, really nice. And quite valuable, I believe. It is. Do you want me to just... Yeah. Grab that lid. I don't want to whack you with it.
No, yeah, well, I'm used to that.
You shouldn't say things like that on the internet.
I do. No, they're witness to it.
I do not whack my wife. Honest. This is an accordion. Now, my grandfather on my dad's side had a very similar one, which is still in the family. It might have even been a Hohner. Do you want to, maybe, can you put that on the floor? Mind those cups. Ooh. But I'm not going to attempt to play it.
Oh, it smells.
Or should I?
It smells vintage.
It smells. It smells like... Oh, hello. Yeah. So, how do you unhook? Ah, here we go. Shall I?
Starley said, can you play it?
No,
I'll
I can't.
No.
Yeah, I was saying my grandfather had one and he taught himself. He never had a lesson in his life. He taught himself how to play it and he could learn songs by ear. So he used to listen to carols, Christmas songs, and then learn to play them by ear. I can't even open it. Oh no, we're in.
Should I move the microphone away? Deafen people.
So yeah, you've got like a piano keyboard bit over here.
Moving the microphone away.
And then I don't know. Oh, these are like chords. So yeah, I have no clue what I'm doing.
Everybody's deaf now.
Is that a bit loud? But, I haven't looked into it in any depth. Hohner is a good make. There are different models of this. This is what's called a Student 5. But I think we're looking in the hundreds. I do need to do some more research, so don't quote me on that. But I briefly looked over it earlier. There's no real damage that I can see.
Yeah.
General wear
and tear. Question for me before it disappears. AER sales, I think. Said Andrea, I'm thinking of selling clothes on eBay. Out of 100 sales, how many returns do you think you get? I don't really know out of 100 or what percentage I get. What would you say?
Probably
very low. I get very low percentage.
2 or 3%.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah.
You've you don't tend to do big volume. You're trying to lean towards smaller numbers of higher quality items.
Yeah, because
it'd be better to ask someone like Karen, who sells a lot of volume, what her percentage of returns is. That'd be an interesting question.
Because I sell clothes, but obviously it's not the, I don't special, you know, it's not the only thing that I sell. So
yeah, that is one of my favourite items from the haul. Really nice. I love the colour as well. Look at that.
Yeah, I know, it's a gorgeous colour.
Right. Do you want to grab the box and I'll stick it in?
Tom just spat his drink out.
Oh dear. Just
Can you place that? Shall I show my mugs?
Place that gently in your box.
Right.
Yeah.
Look at these. They're absolutely stunning. They're Epcot. Like, I don't know, what would you describe them as? They're glass, I think. Yeah.
Are they meant to be
sort of
mugs?
silver glass, like what's the word for it? Like
I don't know,
it escapes me.
They look really dated to me.
Maybe like sort of latte mugs or...
Oh, yeah, they could be fancy. What do you reckon? Are they fancy coffee mugs? They're glass with a silver coating on. And these are from Epcot, which is...
Raised and sparkling.
How do you describe Epcot? We went to... It's a Disney park.
It's one of the parks in Orlando.
Hot toddy mugs, says Karin.
Oh, maybe.
Latte mugs, yeah, JD Network.
Latte mugs.
When did Sid James
Irish
walk
coffee.
In?
Yeah, it's a couple of people said Irish coffee.
Show your mugs, but not your jugs. All right?
Okay.
Look at that pair of jugs. Goblets.
Oh, yeah, that's the word I was looking
was
for.
Was it?
Goblets.
Okay. Yeah. Harry Potter and his goblet of Epcot Center. Epcot was really good, actually. I really enjoyed it there.
So they, I thought they were really cool. I really like them.
Yeah, I haven't looked them up. Or do have you looked them up?
No.
No idea if there's any value, but they're just quite a cool item.
Oh, Daisy May said those Epcot mugs are 80s or 90s. I had some.
Okay.
Cool. What did you get for them?
Do you mean you've had some that you owned or you bought them to sell?
Yeah. Mm-mm-mm. Oh, goblets don't have it. Yeah, that is true, Sapphire. Goblets don't have a handle. But that was the word I was looking for. I think maybe Irish coffee mugs. But they are glass. So, don't know.
Goblets don't have a handle. Oh.
Yeah.
Fwah, nice goblets. Right, what else did you have?
Oh, she said I meant I had them from going there.
Okay. Well, we'll look into them and find out what they go for. As a pair, they'll sell much better, I think.
Yeah,
do you reckon, or would you sell them?
I think so. I'd sell them as a pair.
Yeah.
Another
cool thing. There's so much electronics in this hall. If there's one camcorder, there must be about 10 video players, DVD players, amps, all of that sort of stuff. But I found this in one of the boxes when I was going through, which is a really cool item in itself. It's a little Olympus dictaphone, but it's a digital one. So you don't have to put an analog tape in it. So it records it onto an inbuilt memory. But I put it in my pocket so I could bring it back in here and put it in the pile to get listed quick. Somehow, that was last Thursday, and I actually went to poker with it in my pocket. So it was in my pocket all night. At some point, I managed to turn it on whilst in my pocket and start playing one of the files on it. So that night, we were sat there watching TV. It was quite late, wasn't it? And I kept saying to Andrea, I can hear people talking. I think there's people out on the road having a chat or something. So we'd turn the TV volume down and you'd be like, I can't hear a thing. So this is going in my pocket, just going.
I know. Well, I couldn't hear it. I suppose you could hear it louder because it was in your pocket.
Yeah. But then you went off to bed.
No, we both ended up we were in the bathroom and I'm brushing our teeth and I could still hear it. And I went, oh, that's what it is. There's somebody outside.
Well, after that.
Somebody in their garden having a party or chatting in their garden.
So
that's
we decided at that point it was the neighbours out having it in the garden, right? And then you went to bed. I came back down and I could still hear it. And wherever I went in the house, it was following me. And eventually I turned the telly off. I just stood quietly and I realized it was that in my pocket. Brought it out and it was a guy talking about something really random.
There were different voices though, because it was like a conversation.
Yeah. Well, how do I turn it on? I don't even know how I turn this thing on. I can't even do it now. And I think it was yesterday. I've got a very clever bum because it managed to call. It didn't call Carla on this, but I managed to phone up Carla. My bum did.
Well, Carla appears in all kinds of strange places because talking of voices that you can't quite figure out where they're coming from. I woke up in the middle of the night a few weeks back and and I could hear Caroline and Carla having a chat in the office. And I was like, what's going on? Why can I hear Caroline and Carla? And I came down, it was like 4 o'clock in the morning, and there was a YouTube video just blaring out of your office, yeah.
Oh.
With Caroline and Carla just chatting to each other in the middle of the night. So I don't know how that happened.
Fantastic.
Frightened the life out of me. Thought they were actually in our house.
Chris picked up a tape dictaphone. It had a police operation going on it. A police operation? We use dictaphones. This is Will You Take Less. We used dictaphones to send tapes back and forth to the brother-in-law when he was serving in the Gulf War to keep in touch.
Oh, cool.
Such a cool idea.
Yeah.
Actually hear his voice then.
Oh, Karen says the ghost wanted to watch YouTube. Well, I did think that, to be fair.
Haunted dictaphone, good name for a band. It is a bit. Okay, I was reading something. Pete had a question. Question, so Nick, did you get a trophy for winning the poker league? Yes, but they still haven't got it sorted. I think they're getting it engraved or something. That was the excuse I got last week. First poker game of the new league, I got second place. So it's a good start. Hey, defending my title.
Yeah.
Right, so what else did we have?
It did take quite a long time for you to get the other trophy, I seem to recall.
Did it? I can't remember. Yeah. I don't even know where that one is. Where did that go?
Oh, I think I took it off the shelf for the Christmas things to go up, so it'll go back again. Don't worry, I haven't hidden it.
Right, what else did you pick out from the hall to share?
Oh, these. Oh, carrying on with the Disney theme. These really cool little things.
Oh, yeah. We only managed, I tried to find out if these have any value. They're not particularly old. And we managed to find, wasn't it just that Donald?
Yeah.
And somebody was trying to sell him for like 15 quid or something.
Yeah. So you put batteries in this one.
Yeah.
So this is Mickey.
Oh. Time to giggle. You rock. Gosh. Pal, you're the best. Just... The cheers.
Is there not a way that you can make him just open his mouth?
Yeah, you pull his head back like that.
It's a very odd concept, I have to say. They're quite cool as figures.
So, yeah, we've done...
Aren't they?
Where's my magic fun glass? Yeah. I can't read where they're from.
Oh, do you want me to have that? I think they were Mattel, weren't they?
Oh, maybe.
2011 Mattel Disney. Mickey Mouse, the remix.
So, yeah, they're interesting. Do you want me to put the batteries in another one?
Kind of.
I got a screwdriver out, especially, and then lost it.
Yeah. So, what else? Oh, yeah, this. I showed this when we were collecting it, actually. It's the fashion wheel. That's one of my favourite things out of the haul. Mainly because I remember for a couple of Christmases in a row, I really wanted this and it was on my list and I never got it. So finally have one, but I'm not going to use it because it's worth reselling, isn't it?
I don't know where I put that screwdriver, you know. I've put it somewhere.
Oh, it doesn't matter. So you said it's complete. You've had a look at it.
Oh, this is in immaculate condition.
Yeah.
Look at the box for a start.
I know, it's gorgeous. It looks like they bought it and never used it.
Ignore that.
Barely used it.
And I didn't get it listed in time for Christmas. We had so much going on, but people were achieving up to 30.
Have a date on the back of
up
that.
To £30 and beyond.
Oh yeah, 1987.
87.
Oh, so, it must have been an earlier version than I wanted because I was 13 in 87.
Over 20 years old. And there were very few on eBay that were in this condition. Now, how it works, do you remember how this works? There's your instructions.
Yeah, it's like you trace over.
Yeah.
You put paper on and then you trace over.
So you've got this revolving thing. So you've got like skirts and shoes.
Yeah, and then you've got the top and then you've got a head.
Top and head. So you revolve these somehow. I don't know how to hold it without wrecking it. Oh, there you go. These rotate.
Yeah.
And then you put paper under there. Is that right?
Yeah. And then you just rub over with a pencil.
Well, that
or,
thing.
Yeah.
It's got that. Like graphite in it. And look at that. I swear that's not been used. Or if it has, barely at all. And that is usually missing or very, you know, flat because it's been used. So you would rub over your piece of paper and you would get your outline.
These pencils look like they've been used.
Oh, right. Yeah, barely at all, though.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So it's been lightly used, I think.
But that's really cool.
It's very cool. But, I mean, honestly,
what?
Kids these days are looking at it and thinking, you do what with it?
You draw a picture and then have to colour it in? Sounds like hard work. Yeah, you can see what you end up with on there. So you'd end up with a black
outline.
Yeah, it shows
on the back as
well.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Anyone have one of these in the 80s? Anyone want to admit to being that
old? Yeah, Tara says, I had one. I loved mine. Yeah, they were for the time, they were really, really cool. I can imagine kids these days getting a bit bored with them because they don't do enough. I think that sort of thing just goes to collectors, doesn't it? Or people who enjoy sort of vintage toys.
Yeah. Or I think a lot of these are people, like you might mention in passing, oh, I had when I was a kid a fashion wheel or whatever. And then somebody like me thinking, what on earth do I buy Andrea? Goes on eBay and buys one. Yeah. I think there's a lot of that goes on.
Yeah.
I was just going to say, I did a video last night, which I really enjoyed. And I know a bunch of you guys watched and really enjoyed where I found online a vintage Argos catalogue and was looking at prices of this sort of stuff from back in the day. I found one of these in an Argos catalogue and they were so cheap compared to what you might imagine they'd be. It's all to do with inflation and everything. But yeah, so I'm going to do more of those videos because that was so much fun.
Well, Tara had one along with her Crayola colouring station.
Lights Alive was the best. Now that rings a bell.
I remember that. Yeah.
What was that? Did you draw with lights or something?
I thought about that for a long time.
How did it work?
I can't remember. I remember, suddenly thought, oh yeah, I remember them.
I remember the name.
It's the weirdest thing.
Mouseketeers.
Yeah, but he doesn't really say. You know, you have to keep opening his mouth.
Yeah, anyway, what else have we got? As you can tell, this haul was quite varied and random.
Four collapsed and then Mickey said, gosh.
Right. This is a bit out there. Do you know what this is?
A cupping set.
Do you know what it does?
No.
I'll show you. I don't think this has any value. It was just made me laugh.
Emily, I could go off you.
They're like little boobies. What it is, is a kind of, it's not really a massage. It's kind of a therapy thing where I think normally they're done with little glass jars. Yeah.
Sorry, I was just reading silver hair. Stacker said, dictaphone with Mickey voice would be awesome. That'd be quite funny.
Jackie B, breast enlargement? How's that going to enlarge your breast? You must have pretty small breasts if that's going to enlarge it. Look. How's that? What? No, what these are, you know, it's like a kind of spa therapy thing. People put little glass things on your back.
Oh, yeah.
And generally they put hot air in, and then as it cools, it draws blood to the surface. But these, you have a little vacuum thing, right? And you go...
That's bizarre.
Do you want to go later?
No.
On your back?
I do not.
Yeah, you do.
No.
You so do. You want to go on this?
I really do not.
And there's like...
It's bizarre.
You've got funny shape ones, little skinny ones.
Oh, that's really, really strange.
Oh, I thought I'd have a big red mark on there. Oh, almost, look.
That reminds me of our boss at our place.
Yeah. Did we share that story? I
probably
think we did. Probably. Might as well share it again. It was about the time we got together. We were working in St. Albans, getting stock ready for the launch of the Virgin Megastore in Stevenage.
And he was messing around. And he had, what did he have?
Well, we used to have these suckers that you put on the windows at the front of the shop to hang posters on in the shop window. So he's prattling around trying to be, you know, cool boss. Yeah, look at me, I'm silly. And he stuck one of these on his head. And then he couldn't get it off. He's pulling and pulling it. Eventually it came off. And he had this massive, perfect circle where it burst all the blood vessels in his head. And it stayed for...
I know, it did for days, didn't it? It was
weeks,
hilarious.
I think.
We had lots of fun making fun of him for that.
Oh, bless him. Andy, if you're out there, what a guy. Yeah, so I don't think there's much value in that. It was just a funny little thing to share.
Yeah, it was... It marked because it bruised, I think.
Yeah.
This red mark for ages.
Walt Disney was a dodgy guy, apparently. What are we talking about now? Forehead, do it. No, no.
Yeah, Emily's not a fan of Disney.
Okay, fair enough. Those are cute little suckers. Yeah.
Yeah. I remember seeing like pictures of celebrities with coming out of spas with like round circles on their backs.
Well, they've been messing with this. Yeah. Hey, Pommy Pickers is in. I was saying earlier that we're going to try and hook up for not next Thursday, the Thursday after, for a hangout. So yeah, hopefully we'll get that happening. Nipple enlargements then, says Jackie. I'm just scrolling back. It's a bondage kit, Dave. Trust you.
Oh, apparently Gwyneth Paltrow brought it to fashion.
Did she?
According to Love the Sea. It doesn't surprise me, I have to say.
Stu Mandry, I'm thinking some sort of sexual aid for under-endowed pygmies. Should we end that there?
I think we should, on that note.
That's a sentence I didn't expect I'd say this evening.
I did read it and I was ignoring it. What else have we got to show?
I think you're ahead of me because you shared a couple.
Okay.
Should I do another one?
Yeah.
What's the largest one? I think I showed you the largest one. They're not very big. Okay, I'm scrolling to the end. My dad did that with a plunger when we had chemo. What, he stuck a plunger on his head? That'd leave a massive... You'd have to have a big forehead to get a plunger on it. Nick, have you seen the new long-term storage fees for Amazon? Nope. That doesn't sound good. Okay. Right. So I've shared that.
Oh, Emily says, just to clarify about Walt Disney, not in that way, but apparently a real bully. Possibly. I don't know. I don't know anything about him, to be honest with you. Like the characters that he created.
Followed up with all geniuses are psychos.
Well, not all, but there's a lot of madness in genius.
It's a thin line. I'm no genius, so you can't count me in it. You may have seen again in the hall. I thought there may have been two of these, but it's actually the other one that's in a hard case like this is a Sony, and I don't think it's particularly good. I had one of these last year.
Now, some people are asking about long-term storage fees and what you think about it.
Yeah, I read that. I haven't seen anything about it yet.
I thought you said you read the email. I told you about it.
Nope.
Oh, okay.
So this is another one of the old Back to the Future cameras, but this one is in better condition. This one is so nice. The one I had before, this grip was all knackered and the top of it was all falling apart. The other one didn't work. I haven't tested this one yet. I'm hoping this is going to work. But as a non-working one, the last one sold for 90, I believe it was, wasn't it? So I'm hoping I'm going to get this one working. If the rechargeable batteries that are in here don't work, I know that Mukhtar's already offered to send me the power adapter for it again, which would be fantastic. So hopefully it's going to work. Look at that, though. Look at the condition of that.
That is pretty awesome. I just quickly want to read. A Snowy Journey says, hello, watching you for ages now, binge watching. It's given me the confidence to start reselling and vlogging my journey. Thank you so much. That's really cool.
Wow. So you're vlogging.
So is that your YouTube channel, A Snowy Journey? Because if so,
I'll try I'll try and do it now. Can I do it now? Go over to channel. Snowy Journey.
Awesome.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, we're subscribing.
Subbed. Done. There we go. Yeah, I'll take a look when we get a chance. Yeah. I'm glad you're enjoying the videos. Binge watching us.
I know.
Wow.
I'm sorry.
There's a concept. Anyway, I'm thrilled about that. That's a really nice object if you're into that sort of thing. But you know what's annoyed me? Do you know what's annoyed me?
Oh, many things.
Many things. But today, I realised there are no cassettes in here.
Oh.
This is VHS-C. I don't have a VHS-C tape anywhere in this office.
Oh.
The last one had about like 7 or 8 tapes in.
Oh, and
I didn't keep one as a tester.
No, that was a silly thing to do.
I'm sure I'll be able to find one somewhere.
Yeah, I'm sure you'll be able to pick one up.
But that's just so annoying. I had the chance to just keep one or two as testers.
Yeah. Yes. Oh, hi, Michael. MS just arrived.
Hey.
Said I'm late to the party. Haven't missed much, really.
Michael.
Just us waffling on about things.
Loving these. I thought these Swedish fish were like the salted ones that Kenneth sent us, but they're not. Yes. They're like just little red fish.
Oh.
I've eaten half the packet today.
Are they gelatine free? Because I haven't tried them yet.
Oh, I don't know. You'll have to read. And the sour ones, Sour Patch Kids, were they?
Oh, yeah, they are. No, well, stop hogging them. I'll try some later.
Oh, right. Well, you have them.
Because I thought they might be the salty ones as well.
I'm trying to find a packet. These Sour Patch Kids.
Oh, yeah,
Kids,
you finished those off, didn't
they?
You?
Lasted like about an hour.
Right. I shall try some of those later.
I think that's it, though, when they've gone. That'll be the last of the sweets. So, yeah, thanks, Michael, for sending them over. Your favourite. Yes, Andrea can eat them. Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, Snowy Journey. Do you want to read that?
But, you know, Nick's been hogging them in here. I haven't had a lick in on them yet, have I?
Well, I didn't know you could eat them ones.
No. Oh, you did a faux pas with Ellen, didn't you? You offered her some of the those pumpkin sweets or whatever they are. And you said, here, try one of those. So she ate some. And then I said, it's got gelatine in it. She's like, oh.
Oh, yeah. It's all right. One won't kill her.
Oh, I know.
Can you just read what Snowy Journey has said in response?
Yes. Says, oh, thank you. You're great to watch, honest and real, showing the ups and downs of reselling. You gave me the confidence. My channel is All Sorts. That's cool. We like All Sorts.
Excellent. Right. So if you're late to the party tonight, we are just sharing a handful of bits. I mean, items wise, it's probably, I don't know, 500 to 1,000 items in this haul. It's crazy.
There's a lot of talk, especially from Karin, about the Marie Kondo tidying up program on Netflix. I haven't watched it yet. I've added it to my list.
Watch the whole series in a day. Holy moly. Tidying up?
Yeah.
I've got enough.
It's about organising and tidying.
Oh, okay. I'd probably get into that, but applying it to my own life, I'm not sure.
We do need to organise our wardrobe and everything else. So maybe we can get some hints and tips from it.
Our bedroom needs an overhaul, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So, I was just saying, if you've just joined us, we are trying to just share a few highlights from the haul. There's no way we can share everything that we got in that van load. So we picked out a few items that appeal to us or are interesting or funny or amusing. Now, this is something that caught your eye when we started filling the van. Put it around there.
I've just sold a pair of shoes. I've marked them down to £10. They were the vintage shoes that I bought at the Jumble for 50p.
Okay.
So.
But it just it goes to show. I mean, we're having a big clear out. I'm yet to start reducing my stuff and getting rid of stuff, but marking down your stuff and relisting
it cheaper at the moment
has generated sales almost instantly. Yeah. So it's great.
So that's cool. Yeah, I love this. It's a shame it's not a double tape deck.
Yeah,
but it's really cool.
It's made by Sharp.
Yeah,
There's a few different colors available in this. I think the red one is quite popular. Mm. The white seems to be quite uncommon, but there's not a great deal of value. I thought it'd be worth more.
Yeah,
but like you said, I think if it was a double, it might have fetched more.
Mm.
Or maybe Sharp isn't a particularly popular brand. It just looks so 90s or maybe
really
80s.
90s, late 80s, early 90s.
Yeah. So yeah, that was one of your favorite items.
Yeah, I like that.
Prices, I've seen these go between 20 and 30, so there's not a great deal in it. So if you do see them when you're out and about, don't spend a lot on them, but they're worth picking up if you see them cheap. Not tested yet. I've probably got many days, if not a week, flat out if I went at it flat out to try and test all the electronics in this hall. So much of it. I think I'll have to do it in small batches. So yeah, that was cool.
Karen says, seriously, Nick and Andrea, I had that too. So that fashion wheel and bed bugs who seriously went in a time machine and robbed my bedroom.
Well, you had
blame
this
Luke. It's all Luke's fault.
Yeah.
I found 9 for you to choose from. Hot tub time machine, the time machine, 1960, the time machine, 2002.
Siri, shut up.
Hot tub time machine 2, time machine, 2016, time machine,
shut up,
2018.
Siri.
Felix, the toy rabbit and the time machine.
Oh my God.
Oh my goodness.
Who rattled her cage?
No, she's going on about time machines. It was all Siri's fault.
Wow. Dave says, yes, 20 to 30 is about right. Yeah, that's what they seemed to be going for when I looked up earlier. The red and white seemed to be a little bit more popular from what I could see. Well, I remember the Sharp. Everyone wanted a red one. Yeah, exactly. Nick, do you have to pat test electrical items? No, you don't have to. I don't think there's... We've had this discussion before. Mm. And depends how comfortable you are with selling electrical items, but I don't. So, yep. Take that as you will. Nick's office is haunted. Yes, Tom. Yes, had that Sharp and the fashion wheel and the game bed bugs. Wow.
I think it's because I said, seriously.
Oh, seriously.
And it thought I was talking to it.
Your phone is listening.
It is. It so is. I mean, you must get this as well, that whenever you talk about something, then you go on Instagram or Facebook or something and you get advertised it. Crazy.
Mm. That is powerful, isn't it? Big Brother's listening to your conversations
Blows
and then trying to sell you weird stuff related to conversations.
I showed you something recently as well, didn't I? I said, just to prove to you my phone listens, look what it's trying to sell me now. Oh.
Steve survives on pigeons and tank water. Is Steve living in the loft now? Is that what's happening?
I think so. George says, as sellers, all we have to do is a physical pat test. Basically, use your common sense, and if wires are exposed, then it's a fail. Yeah.
Yeah, common sense rules in this game.
Just to make sure it's in good condition. Yeah.
Okay. Steve says, I want to go live from everyone's loft for charity. Now, that's a challenge.
Oh, that sounds like an interesting challenge.
There's just about room in ours.
Just about. There's a walkway.
We can supply you with tea and, you know, let you get on with it. I will check your pockets when you leave.
Hi, Helen. She says, first time in your live. Yeah. Yeah. Hope you've had a good Christmas, Helen.
Is that Helen that we
met? Helen Churchill, yeah.
At the meetup.
Yeah.
Oh, hi, Helen. Richard says, I don't pat test anything, but sometimes charity shops have already pat tested items. Yeah, when I pick up electricals from a charity shop and it has the pat test on it, just put that in your listing. It might give someone confidence to buy it. But yeah, beyond that, I don't bother with it. Okay. I'm just going to get to the end of the chat. Right, more stuff. Yeah, this, somebody over on the chat Facebook group, if you're not already on there, it's a social group for resellers. There's a link below in the description. Anybody is welcome, part-timers, full-timers, pretty much anybody. It's not for tattooists or tattoo artists.
Yeah, we get a lot of requests, even though I've now changed the description and said this is, you know, so it's very clear what the group is.
The group name is the Tat Chat for resellers and thrifters.
Yeah, I know. It's very obvious what it is, but we still get requests from tattoo enthusiasts.
At least a couple of times a week, there'll be member requests and I'll go in and one will be like a bloke with just tattoos all over and pictures of tattoos.
You know, and what, now I'm going to get advertised lots of things to do with tattooing.
Yeah, Google is listening. Anyway, on the Tat Chat, I think it was last week, somebody was in a charity shop and they shared a picture saying, does anyone know what this is? And it was a picture of this guy.
Oh, he's weird. And freaks me out.
And a few people, including myself, replied and explained that it is a Yano.
Oh.
I've never had one of these. This is, again, part of this haul. This was a boxed one, and it's a storyteller.
just read.
What?
I get very excited, too.
Oh. He gets very excited. Now, there's an excited face. Oh, dear.
When we're through playing, I go to sleep.
Oh, hang on. There's a scared face. He's got a scared face. Oh, there's me at the top. Look. Look at grumpy face.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear.
I know. It's freaky.
Yano having a bad day. Yano getting excited. Oh, no, that's scared. Sorry.
Oh, Mandy said she had one without a box and sold it for 35.
Oh, well done. I briefly looked at it and there didn't seem to be a great deal of completeds that were doing much, but blimey. Yeah, he's quite ugly.
Yeah.
And he's got mucky. He needs a clean.
Yeah, he does need a clean. Get the baby wipes on him.
But yeah, so if you see that knocking around at the boot sale, so some, what was that? 30 unboxed somebody
35
got?
Unboxed.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Burn it with fire, Tom. I'll only get hate. You know that video with the Furby?
Oh, oh my goodness.
I've been getting some messages on there. Go and check them out. They're quite, they're funny in one
evil.
Way.
You're evil.
Yeah, one woman.
Oh,
flipping heck. That freaked the bejesus out
of
me.
That's because I said evil.
Take a picture of a fish.
Take a picture of a fish. I'll take a picture
how
of a fish.
How do you make
it? Okay, bye-bye.
Oh, bye. Yeah, don't come back.
Is that him waving? Is that a wave? That. Bye-bye now. How did I wake
up? Do you want to make a wish? Press the green yes button or the red no button.
Oh. Oh,
green
dear.
Wish button.
Press the yellow wish button to make a wish.
Oh, let's make a wish, guys. I wish you'll shut up. Did you make a wish?
I believe your wish will come true.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, he's smiling.
If it's meant to be.
Oh.
Oh, he's gone to sleep. Okay, I'm loving that now.
He's got a hole in his cheek.
Oh, he's got a little bit of a hole,
a little
in, his
hole in his cheek.
Oh, that freaked me out. Anyway, it looks like you can get like add-on packs. So this is like a cartridge and I don't know.
Take it away from me.
And there's sorry. Yeah, do you want to cuddle
no,
him for
I
a
really
minute?
No, I don't. I don't want to touch it.
And there's
it.
This that looks like some sort of control pad for it. I don't know how it works. I've really not had it out of the box before and didn't know it had batteries in and was working. So, yeah.
Okay.
As usual, if anything that we show you really want to buy, just message me. I'll do your deal.
Yeah,
if you
please,
want
please,
that.
Please buy this. Take it away.
George says, hide the knives when you go to bed, Nick. He'll be at the end of the bed with one when you wake up.
I have nightmares. Oh.
A Furby got frisky with a German Shepherd. Is that the result? That thing coming alive on a stormy night. Oh, wow.
No, I'm serious. I had a really bad nightmare when I was small about my girl's world thing. You know, when it's like a headless thing that you style its hair.
Mm.
And I dreamt that it was floating towards me with its hair doing this and evil eyes. And I couldn't play with it after that. I'm going to have nightmares about that, don't you?
I'm just scrolling back to see what people thought about the Yano.
Oh, our troll says, kind of want him. You're welcome.
Yeah. Take a picture of a bitch. Is that what he said? Take a picture of a bitch.
What he said? I didn't hear that.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, Purple Vamp says, my eldest son had a Yano. I'm going to sell it, but the accessories are scattered all over the house. Creepy little thing. Oh, yeah.
Michael M. Mass says, hurry, smash it with a hammer. Well, if I can get 30 quid for it, worth flogging.
No.
It's like a Chucky doll. Ah, yeah, maybe. Wow. Looks like he's had too much to drink. DBG doesn't like him. The evil spawn child of Dungeon Master and an Ewok.
Steve says, I'll pay you £35 right now. Shoot it right between the eyes.
Shoot it between the eyes.
Yeah.
Maybe I should get those suction cup things and stick them to it.
Yeah. Just don't film it and put it on YouTube because we'll get hate mail.
Don't get it wet either. It's not a gremlin, Tom. It's not a gremlin.
How do you know? Might be distantly related.
Hugh has a good point. Check the batteries are not leaking. Mind you, if they got to the point when they were where they were leaking, I doubt it would power it. But yeah, I will take those old batteries out. Yeah. Ah, dear.
Oh, dear me.
He just wanted to tell you a bedtime story in the night. Yeah. Hi, Kenneth. How are you? Head and shoulders above the rest. It's a girl's world. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah. That was the tagline, wasn't it?
Mm. Yeah. See if you could get the Yano to talk to Siri.
Oh, no.
I could do a video.
Totally freaked me out.
I could do a video of that. Couldn't I? I could say, hey, Siri, and then get that thing to talk. I could do it with a Furby. I think somebody's done Furby.
How come your phone didn't talk to you when you said that?
I don't know. My phone doesn't like talking to me. I can understand that, to be fair. Yano, the depressed storyteller. Okay, what else did we have?
George says, with batteries, batteries don't power him. Evil spirits do.
The dust is getting to me.
It is. Right, was there anything else left that you wanted to show?
Yeah. Oh, dear. Oh, yeah. Another one of your favourites. Didn't hang on.
The Hills keeps going on about a Sony box. What Sony box?
Sony box?
Don't really know what Sony box.
I don't know what Sony box.
We're talking about
this. Yeah, I think we really talked heavy, about in the hall video.
And I think I showed it when we got it, when we put it in the van.
Yeah.
It's really, really cool.
It's very obscure, and I think it's going to be a list it and wait kind of item. I've seen people listing them for anywhere between about 60 and a couple of £100. I don't think I've seen any sold. So it's obscure. It is I think it's black and white TV with a built-in cassette player of all things. So there's the cassette controls on the top. It's made by Hitachi. And it's just pretty random. Not tested.
Still talking about the Yano thing. Tom says, what would you do if you opened him and it didn't have any batteries in? Definitely burn it.
Can you imagine?
Yeah.
I do like the idea of the Yano talking to Siri, though. Okay. I might try and see if that works. I can make a video.
Yeah.
Wow, that will end up on a film set. Well, maybe. It's.
I've never seen anything like this, to be honest.
No. We were quite intrigued by it.
Mm.
So it's one of those. Yeah, list it and wait, I would imagine.
Oh, George says, that's awesome. I had one a couple of years ago that sold for £80. But I had to wait.
Yeah.
Oh, bye, Steve.
See you later, Steve. So you got 80 for it. Okay. Yeah, I'd seen, I think when I searched recently, this particular model number, it was a couple of people trying to, one was listed at about 60 and I think the other was at 100 and something. I think the day we got the haul, I randomly looked this up and somebody had been trying to get a couple of hundred and it hadn't happened. It's probably the same person that's now got it on at about 150, slowly dropping it. But yeah, I will get it listed if it works. I'll get it listed if it doesn't work as well.
Wayne has a good point. It says, very 80s, will it show Channel 5? Or will it even show Channel 4, to be honest?
Well, there's no signal now anyway for this, is there?
No, probably not, to be fair.
I get confused at all of that. This won't even work at all, will it? Right? Because it's all gone digital.
So you'd need to set it as a prop.
I guess so.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so heavy. Damn.
Yeah, I think BBC have gone completely HD now, haven't they?
Oh.
I don't think you can get any analog BBC on TV now. It's all changed.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Hey, Dwayne, how are you doing?
What was the other thing? Was it that cookie jar?
Yeah. Karen got all excited with a ka-ching then. Another silly offer. What is it with half price offers? Or is that just me? What is it with the half price?
Yeah, well, that is why I do a minimum on my offers. I cap it so I don't have to put up with stupid offers.
So auto rejects.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, because it drives me mad when people make stupid offers. So just waste your time, I think.
Works with a Freeview box, says Vintage Vandal. George says, we're talking about the TV, you won't get a signal, but retro gamers might be able to wire it up. Yeah, well, of course, you could use it if you're using an RF cable from a console, because that's where you get your signal from. Mm. But I'm pretty sure that's black and white, so nobody's going to want it for gaming, I wouldn't
think. Marcella said, could you hook that TV up to a DVD player and use it that way?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You could potentially run a video machine through it or something like that. It won't have SCART on it.
Couldn't you connect the camcorder to the Hitachi TV?
Potentially, yeah. Potentially. It is, yeah. We'll have to see what inputs it's got. Yeah, Lisa says it would be cool to play video games on, but if it is black and white, it would be, yeah, very retro. There's also collectors out there who will pay just for display, says George. Yeah. Well, it was George who recently sold a vintage CRT TV to PewDiePie. Do you know who I'm talking about?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
Yes.
The biggest YouTuber there is, and I believe it's in the backdrop of his videos now. Mm. I haven't watched PewDiePie.
Gary says there's no analog signal at all now. So no. What am I meaning then, the BBC? What? Well, there was a BBC, a normal BBC and one, and a BBC One HD. So what's
your
that?
HD is how the high definition as opposed to normal.
Well, I'm talking about normal.
But they're both digital.
Oh, okay.
As opposed to the old analog system.
Okay.
Yeah, I get confused.
Yeah, I do.
Okay, so we were going to share a few things. We're nearly done. You wanted to share this guy who caught your eye.
Yeah, he's really cool. You looked him up, didn't you?
I looked him up. But I couldn't find this one. It's made in England.
Yeah.
By P&K.
P&K Bassett.
And oh, it's a Bassett. This is a Bassett. But there's also another one that's has a different face, different kind of dog. That I found a bunch of. So I don't know if this one's harder to find or something.
Yeah, I don't know, but it's really cool.
But the other ones were going for around 20, I think, tops. Mm. But here's a cookie jar or biscuit barrel. Yeah, he was in the hall, so we're going to try and do something with him.
Yeah, well, I really like him.
Sell him, essentially. I can't see any damage. A few little nicks on the paint, but nothing.
Yeah, nothing major.
Nothing major. He's not a very happy dog. He hasn't had a bad day.
DBG, so he's cute. He is.
Yeah. So there was that caught your eye.
Yeah, I like him.
And oh yeah, I was going to show you this before my favourite item of the whole haul, which I'll show you in a second. Now, I've never seen this. You know those Bop It things that we all see everywhere? Bloody annoying little game.
Karen says, seriously, Luke has a time machine. We had that too.
I think Luke...
We have the contents of your old house.
This is Karen again. Yes. Were you burgled in the 80s by a young... But it would have been a very young guy called Luke. In fact, I don't think he was alive in the 80s.
No, probably not. Well, very
Luke,
young
if you're watching... We know what you did in the 80s. That is weird. Anyway, you know Bop It's that we all see everywhere? Really annoying things that go flick it, spin it, all of that. This is a spin-off called a Top It. And it has a little like hacky sack. And I was working it out earlier how you play it. So you go.
Let's play Top It.
Right. Oh, hang on.
Top It. Top it challenge. Top it pass it.
Right.
Load it. Top it. Top it.
Flop it is keep it there. Top it is that.
Oh.
Top it.
Top it is that.
Pass it.
Pass it.
No, I don't want to do it.
Okay.
Top it.
Flop it is there.
Top it.
Top it's there.
Okay, I think we get the idea now.
Flop it's there.
Flop it.
Flip it. Flip it upside down.
Flip it.
Flip it.
Pass it.
Pass it. Oh, you don't want it.
No.
Ah! Pass it.
Okay, well, let's turn it off now.
No.
Yeah, this isn't great TV.
It is!
It's not very entertaining.
Go!
George says he needs one. It is pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I couldn't find any of these anywhere, so I don't know if these were like... they tried it out and nobody liked it, so it was a limited run.
Apparently, yeah. Karen had a house fire. She says, unless he started the fire in 2002 just to grab it all first.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Stole it all and then set fire to your house so you didn't realise all your stuff was gone.
Yeah, I mean, well, somebody could have done.
Burglar arsonist.
That is a possibility, isn't it?
Hmm. But yeah, I couldn't find anything on these. So I don't know if that is a rarity or just something that nobody really wants. But I really enjoy playing that.
Yeah.
That's a Top It.
But yeah, I mean, that is really sad, actually, to have lost all your stuff. So
well, you...
if you are interested in replacing anything, or any of your family are, then we've got a few bits.
We've got a house full.
That you could
but you lost,
get in touch about.
Your house was flooded, wasn't it,
oh,
when
yeah.
you were a kid?
Yeah.
And you lost...
I lost tons of stuff, including the girls' world. But yeah, our house, we were looking after my nan, who was quite ill at the time. So we'd moved in with my grandparents. And we got a call one day saying there's water pouring out of your letterbox. And basically what had happened, because it was winter, Mum hadn't left any heating on, pipes had frozen, and we just came back to our house and the ceiling was completely caved in. Yeah, everything was just water damaged.
So the water pipes burst in the loft?
In the loft, yes. Yeah. So
the
ceiling had collapsed.
But surely the neighbours noticed something was going on?
Well, not until there was water pouring out of the letterbox, apparently.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
So we pretty much lost everything. So all of my, I remember having the coolest Miss Piggy, and I wasn't allowed to play with her much because I was supposed to be keeping her pristine. And she was, Mum used to keep her in her wardrobe. So I used to get her out every now and then, have a little bit of a play with her, and then she had to go back in the wardrobe. She was the coolest thing. She was poseable. She was about this big.
Miss Piggy?
Miss Piggy.
Oh, I bet that'd be and worth a fortune.
Yeah, she's gone now.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow. We've got some comments coming in on the Top It. Dwayne says sells for about $20. So that's obviously in America. Oh, George says bin it. $19.99 Top It. Okay.
BCP.
Maybe Yano set the house
Andrea
on fire.
Andrea didn't like the Top It. She wanted Nick to stop it. Stop it. I was just thinking it wasn't great, you know, watching material.
That was our best minute of material ever on this channel, I'll have you know. Starly says, Nick, that Top It is what happens when Skynet takes over the cup and ball game. Yeah, it's like a modern cup and ball game, isn't it, essentially? Yeah.
Oh, Karen said it was all mine and my sister's stuff as went up into the loft and all our stuff was right at the start of the loft. Oh, God, that's awful.
Hugh says, bin it. Will you take this? Pile of shame it. Lob it. Lob it, yeah. Adrian's off. See you later, Adrian.
Karen said, I left my first boyfriend that I lived with, went a couple of days later to get my stuff, and he'd sold loads of it, lost all my CD collection. Oh, my God.
Oh, I swear, if somebody had sold my record collection or CD collection, I think I'd have just killed him. Just
note to self.
Just putting that out there. You don't go touching someone's record collection.
Tom said Nick needs to buy one for Andrea now. No, I don't really need a Miss Piggy.
Oh, Miss Piggy?
Yeah. I'm guessing that was what you were meaning.
No. Yeah, I think I need to buy you one of these.
Because Wayne said, yeah, Nick needs to buy Miss Piggy for Andrea's Valentine's
Day. Get you one of these instead. Do you want that? No?
No.
Really?
No, not interesting.
Hours of fun.
Yeah.
Hours.
I did get a lovely present from you, though, didn't I? It was a night away somewhere, one of those sort of box voucher experience things.
Yeah, we're going to a country inn of our choice.
Yeah, so I need to find a weekend to go and do that.
Yeah.
Looking forward to that.
He was a loser. Sounds like it, Karen. I agree with Nick. Yeah. What? Death to all record stealers. And, right. Lex, you know, I caught your video, your last one, like your day in the life thing, was playing while I was sorting out the office yesterday or today. And you mentioned Watership Down and going to see it as a kid. I think I commented on that video. That was, I think, the first film I ever saw as, like, I don't know, 6-year-old or something. When did it come out? And scarred me for life.
I was reading.
Watership Down.
Oh, Watership Down.
It was certainly the first film I ever saw in a cinema, so probably the first film I ever saw.
Yeah.
I love Watership Down, by the way.
I've seen the film when I was younger, and it really upset me, so I didn't want to watch it again. And Nick's been trying to get us to watch it, and I said, no, I don't think, you know, Ellen would be really upset by it. But then we did watch the one over Christmas, because they'd kind of toned that down a little bit.
Yeah, not really.
A little bit, I think. They just kind of changed it up a bit. So we watched that one. I quite enjoyed that. It wasn't too bad.
Yeah, it was okay. I don't know if any of you guys caught the modern adaptation of it. Mm. I found that the visuals weren't great. It was really dark. I mean, I know it's a dark tale, but I mean, the actual visuals were really quite dark in it, and not sure they worked too well. But we did enjoy it, and we watched that. But anyway, the point why I'm mentioning Watership Down is the hall included this. This is lovely. It is the first illustrated edition. And I think it's the first edition of the illustrated edition. I need to do a little bit more research, but I think it's quite valuable. I mean, not super, super valuable. I think I'm looking at about 50, maybe. That's what I'm going to put on it.
It's got a lovely smell.
It has a lovely smell. I think there's a couple of signed ones of this edition that people are asking in the hundreds for, but look at it. Dust. It's just really, really nice. Yeah. And it's got its little slip cover, little hard case.
Yeah. Troll said that Black Rabbit wasn't so bad in the new version, I didn't think. The Black Rabbit.
Right.
It's kind of cute.
I was waiting with a new version at the end where, well, I won't give it away if you haven't seen it, but I was waiting for Bright Eyes to kick in and stuff.
Yeah, it was Sam Smith instead, Fire on Fire.
Yeah.
It didn't have the same impression.
Really didn't work.
Oh, Corin said the first film at the cinema was the Care Bear movie. That wasn't my first one, but it was my cousin's first one. I remember taking Carly to the cinema for the first time.
Really? How old was she then, like 4 or 5?
Yeah, something like that. And that was her first ever film experience. My first film experience was Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band.
How cool are you?
And they've never, ever released that on DVD.
Yeah.
Never. I wish they would, because I want to see it again.
First movies, guys. Well, we'll get into that in a minute. But if that wasn't cool enough, that's my personal favourite item out of this entire haul, just because it's just such a lovely, lovely item. But also, there's a copy of Richard Adams' Plague Dogs in here. And this is the first edition. I think it was this. Probably worth. It's not in great condition. If you can see in the light, the cover, the dust cover's really creased. But it should be a £20 book. I'm pretty sure I was looking at this and it's a first. Yeah, 1977, first published. So,
yeah.
Just really nice. I don't think I'll do the pair. I think they'll go on individually, but just something that you don't see very often. Yeah. And yeah.
Richard says, do books sell well on eBay? I think it really depends what you've got.
Depends what you've got. Yeah. Your bog standard average book, it's not worth the time. No, if you've got something
you
that some
book bundles, don't you?
Bundles sometimes work. Again, it depends what you're selling. Mm. But yeah, rare collectible early editions. As with anything on eBay, don't ask me, go on eBay and just do some searches and do completed items and then resort them by highest price first. And that will lead you down a rabbit warren of interesting topics and subjects of things you can learn about. So that's the best way to do it.
How strange. Claire and Wayne, are you related? Because they both said that just one after the other, The Jungle Book was their first film. Yeah, lots of people are saying.
So we've got first films coming in.
Jason was Rocky 2.
Where did first films start?
I don't know. A bit further up, I think.
Oh, Catherine said, didn't want to watch the new one. Going back to Watership Down. Mm. Bawled my eyes out as a kid. Yeah, I was just scared of the first one. MMAS, never heard of it. What, Watership Down, really? Oh. Perhaps it's more of a UK thing.
It might be.
Right, so we have Care Bear movies. Kevin, that was Karin. First movie, BMX Bandit. So I was talking to my brother-in-law about that the other day. My brother-in-law, Stuart, loved that film as a kid and then re-watched it recently and thought it was awful.
It's the same with most things, isn't it?
Yeah.
The auction professor says, we've sold that same Watership Down book for about $45, which seems to be the average.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Yeah, Lisa was The Lion King. She saw that. It's her first film. Marcy was Willow.
Lion that King, first cool film. Wow, you must be younger than me. I saw The Lion King in America when I was working over there in 94 when it came out. It was in the cinema.
Yeah.
And watched it in a tiny little cinema in a small town. It was just a one-screen cinema with hardly any seats in. Yeah, it's quite an experience.
Yeah.
Tara didn't enjoy the new version at all.
Mm. I liked it better than the original.
Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Your first film? Oh, really? My first film was E.T. Now, I think E.T. Yeah. was the second ever film I saw at the cinema. I was quite a sheltered kid, so Watership Down freaked the hell out of me. E.T. scared the bejesus out of me. The beginning, where he's rustling around in the bushes.
In the dark.
and then he goes out to the shed. And there's something scary in the shit. I was shitting my little boy pants. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. First film for me was Jaws, Chris. Wow. When was that? Was that late 70s? Don't know when that came out.
Yeah, it must be.
Similar sort of time as Watership Down, maybe. Jungle Book, Moonraker. That's a cool first film. E.T. was my first cinema experience, Dave. I remember going to see E.T.
Don't read Tom's.
Tom's? Debbie Does Dallas? I'd believe that with Tom. I remember going to see E.T. and it was literally a blockbuster. The queue in, I went to sit in Stevenage where the old cinema was, and the queue went right round the entire cinema. It's amazing. It's so popular. And it was like that for weeks.
That's why they were called blockbusters, wasn't it?
Well, absolutely. Yeah, because the queue in an American town with blocks used to go right around the block.
Yeah. Right. I remember that at the Stevenage cinema.
Yeah, that's what I just said.
Oh, right. Yeah. I remember queuing for lots of stuff, actually.
Yeah, it used to go round the back, and then there was a garage behind the cinema, and it used to go right up round there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's so weird, isn't it? We wouldn't do that now. Well, we don't, because we book it online.
I know.
You just go in and scan a barcode.
Nothing's the same. I remember queuing for a film. I couldn't tell you what it was. And getting to the front, and then they're going, we're full.
Oh, I know. That was
like,
gutting.
I've just queued absolutely for a freaking gutting. Hour and a half.
Yeah, absolutely gutting.
And they're like, yeah, come back in like 2 hours for the next one. Oh.
Yeah, so you'd end up going off to McDonald's or something with your friends. And
okay. Yeah. Were there any more first films in? Oh, it's just jumped. Oh, hang on.
Yeah, where were we?
Yeah,
talking of films, went to see Mary Poppins today. That was fantastic, absolutely amazing.
Yeah, I didn't go. You guys enjoyed it, though, didn't you? Oh, Tom was only joking. Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. I remember.
Yeah.
I saw that in the cinema.
Yeah,
that was Tom's first.
David was Star Wars.
Star Wars, 1977. That has to be the coolest first film to ever see.
Lex was Black Cauldron.
Black Cauldron. That was an animated Disney, wasn't it?
Yeah, we've got that.
Edward Scissorhands, Erica. That's a cool first ever film.
That was a great film.
Star Wars from Vicky. Return of the Jedi from Andy. Wow, some really cool first films. First film was Jaws. I was 3 and went with my parents to escape heavy rain whilst on holiday. They let you in age 3. Weren't there any restrictions then?
Yeah, I thought it was certified, wasn't it?
I don't know. On holiday in Weymouth. Oh, we know Weymouth quite well, don't we? I laughed at the eyeless head scene, made the entire cinema laugh.
We saw the Titanic in Great Yarmouth, didn't we? In one of those really old theatres. And they had a break in the middle
when
the little lady came out with her ice cream.
that was what, 97?
Yeah,
we'd just got together and I took Andrea away for the weekend to Yarmouth. Rock and roll.
We stayed
in a B&B. It was really nice, and then we went to
it must have been 98.
I probably was then. And it, right on the seafront, was a really vintage old refurbished cinema.
Yeah.
And because it was so long, they had a break in the middle and we went and got ice cream and stuff.
Yeah. That was cool.
Happy days. We should go back there.
Yeah.
Right. First films. Have we done Mad Mardi? I don't know what that is. 12 Trolls. I dragged my brother to see Lion King, as was too cool to go and watch Disney at that age. Richard J. Mitchell says, my first month reselling on eBay, I made £45. Into my second month now, already on 160, I'm vlogging my journey. Oh, okay. I'll just go over to your channel and I'll take a look when I get a chance.
Yeah.
Why is it not coming up?
Oh, there we go.
Okay, right. Done.
Subbed.
Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, first film. Who was that? Mark. One of the Back to the Futures was my first cinema film. That's cool, Daisy.
The Apple Dumpling Gang. I don't think I've ever seen that.
No. I used to hide behind the armchair when E.T. came on the screen. Yeah, it scared me.
Yeah.
Even Shrek scares Nick. That's all right. I'm grown up now. I can handle Shrek just about. I can't do horror films, though.
I saw E.T. on a pirated DVD.
DVD?
No, not DVD. Sorry.
VHS. In 1985, Andrea had DVDs.
I'm the one with the time machine. No, on video, because my granddad used to work for Sony, and he used to go and sort of raid people and seize stuff, and he had E.T. so he brought it home so we could all watch it.
What a dodgy security chat that is. I've got all of these knockoff E.T. let's take him home. Did he sell them down the pub?
No, I don't think he did. No, he gave them in the next day, but you know. Has to be some perks to the job,
right? So people are still sharing their first film. Labyrinth, Gloria. That's cool. It's great.
Herbie Goes Bananas. That was good.
Oh, Willow, Grease. Yeah. Sorry, the chat has jumped.
Karin, you're so cool. Her second film was the My Little Pony film. We'd have got on as children, I think.
You'd have been swapping ponies.
I would have done.
Yeah.
Yeah. Talk, playing with our ponies and our care bears.
Styling your little bodiless head with your little plastic brushes. Yeah, I can see you and Karen. Who Framed Roger Rabbit, Ghostbusters 2 or Santa Claus the Movie? First one of those, I can't think. Can't remember which. Who Framed Roger Rabbit's a great film.
Yeah, it is.
Blues Brothers, what
when
a classic.
We were at Disney World at Hollywood Studios. They had a sort of display of Who Framed Roger Rabbit, didn't they? So we were trying to work out why was that Disney. And I think Touchstone was owned by Disney.
Wasn't it? We were in a restaurant eating lunch. Yeah. And
they had the car.
They had the car, yeah. Bob Hoskins.
No. Yeah, no. Was that his name? I get so confused because there's somebody else that you was called Hoskins that you...
Yeah, I get somebody
Perhaps it is Bob Hoskins.
Yeah, Bob Hoskins. Drove the car, the cartoon car, but he actually sat on just like a little like real car, but it was all stripped back so they could lay over the graphics, you know, the animated graphics. And that little body, that little shell of a car that I think was controlled remotely. I don't think he was even steering and control. I'm not sure anyway. But that was sat in the restaurant that we ate at Hollywood Studios. And me being me, I was over there, I was reading all the pictures and reading all the blurb about it. And I found that fascinating. So, yeah. I can't remember what the restaurant was called. It was down near the Tower of Terror thing.
Yeah, it was. I can't remember. It was a nice restaurant, though.
Yeah.
Michelle Green says, Escape from Witch Mountain. I remember Zoe and Joe Sugg talking about that endlessly because they'd seen this film when they were younger and they couldn't think what it was called. And they kept describing it and eventually somebody has told them it was Escape from Witch Mountain.
I don't remember that. Yeah. Flash Gordon, as Empire Strikes Back, was always full up. Oh, shame. First film, American Werewolf in London.
Wow. Couldn't sleep for a week. Wow.
Couldn't sleep for a week. Not surprised.
I remember walking in and my uncle's watching Salem's Lot. And I sat down and watched it with them. Oh, that was a big mistake. I was very young. It was a very big mistake. I had nightmares.
Did you wet yourself a little?
I'm probably still having nightmares about it, to be fair.
Yeah. Oh, but Richard goes on to say, watched it recently again and I laughed at the rubbish effects. That's the thing.
Yeah.
When you rewatch them, this was a while ago, I rewatched The Thing, which is actually a good film. But when you rewatch that, the effects, they just don't stand up.
We rewatched The Goonies, didn't we? And it wasn't as good as we thought it was.
No, The Goonies was a letdown.
Yeah. Such a shame.
Jaws was certified. I was let in as long as I was quiet.
Oh. I bet that person would have got in trouble.
Yeah, of course you can come in. Just be quiet and hide.
Yeah. I do remember trying to make myself look older. I was actually 13. I was trying to make myself look 15 so I could go and see Crocodile Dundee. I did get in, actually.
I remember with a bunch of friends, we tried to get in to see something like one of the Indiana Jones movies or something. I think it was a 15 certificate. And we all queued for quite a while, got to the front. And one of us, when they just said to us, all right, lads, how old are you? I think it was probably me, just went 13 or whatever we were.
Oh, no.
And everyone went, no! And they're like, out. Yeah. Oh, yeah, they didn't really care. You just had to say, yeah, I'm 15. Yeah. And that was it. I didn't ID you in our cinema.
Yeah, I remember as a 14-year-old going to Woolworths with my Christmas money to buy Thriller on video, not DVD, video. And they said to me at the time, how old are you? And I went, 14. I said, oh, I'm sorry, I can't sell this to you. And I was like, no, why did I say that?
Oh, Claire says, E.T. on Pirate didn't look the same with the eye patch and wooden leg. Wow.
Very funny.
First pirated video I saw was Teenage Mutant Hero Turtles, the movie. It was virtually pitch black throughout.
Yeah, I have to say that E.T., if that dark bit at the beginning, could barely see anything that was going on.
Was it just filmed by someone sat in a cinema on a camcorder?
Probably.
On one of these. Yeah. Somebody had one of these, and they sat there.
Yeah.
Best cinema memory, this is Karen, was going to see Arachnophobia, as was just 12, and spilling popcorn all over the woman in front of me. She was not impressed.
Oh, no.
My second film was Homeward Bound. Yes.
Oh, that's a good film.
Has that got dogs in it?
Yeah, and a cat, I think.
Yeah.
They're trying to find their way home. Yeah, that was a cool film.
I remember when I was at secondary school.
Bye, Starly.
See you. Yeah, I know we've been on forever. we'll leave you soon.
Yeah. Oh, we have. Blimey.
I remember going to see Bigfoot and the Hendersons in, I think it was 87.
Oh, yeah. That was a good film.
It wasn't really a good film.
No, it wouldn't be now, but at the time it was.
It was quite exciting though, because me and a friend from school, you know, got on a bus and went somewhere. We saw it in St. Albans, of all places. In that cinema we drove past not long ago. You know, I pointed it out.
Yeah.
Ah, Karin's mum still has her ponies.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe you two should get together and play with
my
ponies.
My mum got rid of everything. She used to like boot sales to sell stuff, and generally it was all mine. Yeah.
Okay. Wow. Well, thanks for all your chat. I've just moved down to the end. People didn't care as much back in the day. This is Karen. I remember always buying fags for my dad as a kid from the ice cream man. Yeah.
Yeah.
And for those Americans still watching, fags, we our refer cigarettes. To as cigarettes.
Yeah, not something else.
Yeah. Our ice cream man was terrible. He would come round and he'd split packs and sell individual ones to kids. And it was like nobody batted an eyelid. There'd be a queue with loads of adults in, there'd be kids there going, yeah. Could I have one B&H, please?
I regularly went to our off licence to buy my mum's sherry.
Yeah.
As a small child. She had a bit of a deal going on with them, and it was all ready under the counter in a bag, and I just gave him the money, give me the bag, and I'd go back and give my mum a sherry.
So you were buying sherry at what, about... How old were you, 10?
Seven.
Seven?
Yeah.
Wow. Well, there we go. Ours sold cigarettes and whiskey. Whiskey in an ice cream van?
Yeah.
Yes, I used to buy single cigs on the way to school for 8p. 8p. Wow. I used to just get a bubble gum at the bottom of my screwball.
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember that? Yeah. Like a little plastic... Yeah. Cup with a round bit at the end that held you.
Remember that. I wasn't allowed bubble gum though, so I couldn't have had one of those.
Oh, who remembers those things? They were like oysters, like two like what they're called, cornet.
I know what you mean. Yeah.
Cornet, that yeah. stuff that they made the cornets out of.
Yeah,
cones like that, and then inside it have ice cream and then some like marshmallow stuff.
Yeah.
What, were they oysters or something?
Yeah, probably.
I don't know.
They look like oysters. Clamshell.
What did I used to have?
Dwayne says clamshell.
Clamshell. Yeah, was that what they were called?
Yeah.
Clamshell ice creams. Yeah, okay. Yeah. It wasn't just me then. 10 fags were 77 pence, Jason. 10 B&H, 97p. Wow.
Oh, Karen reckons you can still get oysters.
Oh, okay. Oh, might have to get some of them. Yeah. So quickly before we go, what ice cream did you used to have then? I used to like Fabs. I think it was Fabs that had hundreds and thousands on the top.
Oh yeah, they were good.
And Twister, was it a green one?
Yeah, I used to like, and I think they're still doing them, but they're a lot smaller these days. Or it might just be me. But
you're bigger.
You get the solid chocolate in the middle.
Feast.
A feast.
Oh yeah, Feasts were good.
Yeah, I liked that.
Screwball, Lisa. Yeah.
You can buy oyster cornet in Sainsbury's, said Daisy.
You don't get hundreds and thousands now. They're tens and fifties. Everything is less. Yeah, whatever. I remember getting free broken cornets off the ice cream man.
Oh, funny feet. Oh, yeah, I did. I used to love
milk lolly. Feet. Yeah, funny feet. Knobbly bobbly. Was that a thing? Choc ice. Yeah.
And a twister. Yeah, twisters were good.
Twisters. Push-ups, yeah, the ones that you do, and if you push too hard, all of a sudden, whole thing will pop out. Ice cream disaster.
Yeah. Right, shall we go?
Yeah,
I think we should.
Sorry, we've started a whole other conversation now. We're going to have to go. Thank you so much for joining us, for joining in the chat. If you enjoyed it, please leave us a thumbs up. We'll be back Tuesday with a tat chat. Not sure if it's going to be here or on Zahir's.
Yeah, I don't know.
And then Thursday, I'll be on Lonnie's.
I think that the Seller Ladies chat will be back on Friday, but I don't know whose channel that'll be on yet. And yeah, we're going to do a starting to film a weekly vlog tomorrow. But that won't come out for another week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, quickly before I go. Christmas key ring. Super Nintendo pad.
Which you didn't realise you had because it fell out of your packet.
Yeah.
And Ellen had to tell you. Do you realise you get one of those? For Christmas.
Yeah, very cool. Right, yeah. Cheers guys, take care.
Yeah, have a good week everyone.
We'll see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.